This will be about modern Assyrian music, and we're having a very special guest here. This is the first non-linguistic presentation. So we have Abboud Zeitoune here. He's a musicologist. He was born in Syria and then moved to Germany and graduated from university in Germany. He's been researching on Assyrian music for a pretty long time, and he will show us what he's found out, and he will entertain you a little on Assyrian music. This is actually intended to give you an impression of what we will have afterwards, because outside, as you have seen, there are people who are preparing for something special outside. So we're going to have a culture event of Western Asian dance today. And this is just as a pre-celebration of Nowruz. So just see it like this. And the stage is used. I hope you enjoy this.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. It's for me an honor to be here, to stand here in front of many of you. From all over the world, I can say. My name is Abboud Zeitoune. I'm not a musicologist. However, I studied economic, and the field I get in is documenting and archiving music, our Assyrian music. And I will talk about that later during my presentation. My work since the last 15, 16 years are these two books. This is the first book, and this is the second book. This is the first step for us as Assyrians to document our music heritage of the last 120 years. So, I start, first of all, with a short clip, just to show the current situation. It's a very sad video. Let's watch it together. Normally, I give lectures among our community, Assyrian community. I always say we couldn't, as descendants of this heritage, we couldn't save these stones, these monuments, but at least we have to try to preserve our music, our culture today. And this is where I started, is the music to preserve, to document, to archive our music. Just a little introduction to the Assyrians, of course, all of you know the ancient Assyrians, but for the current Assyrians, we live, of course, in Urmia. We have still Assyrians, we have a large community there. Turabdin, Syria, Iraq, this is our ancient homeland, you can say. And today, we are dispersed all over the world, around 3.5 million people, as you see, all around the world. Our language, I don't have to tell you, tell you which language we speak. We have as a basic the Syriac, the classical Syriac, and we have under the Syriac we have of course dialects. I from my own, that's great. I from my own speak the Western dialect or Surite, and we have the Eastern dialect is Surith. I can also speak it, but it's not normal that we can speak both dialects. Normally each side speak their own. So the Assyrians were the first, or are the first Christians who became Christians, who converted to Christianity. And we have four main churches. I belong to the Syriac-orthodox church. We have the Assyrian Church of the East, Chaldean Catholic, Syrian Catholic, and of course other smaller churches. It's not the complete list. So coming to the music, I didn't try or I didn't get to the ancient music because we had a lot of musicologists archaeologists who did this job. So you can see on the stones a lot of musicians, instruments, musical instruments and so on. I will start with the church music, the church music of the Syrian church or Syrian Orthodox church. Many musicologists are the opinion that the music we have in the church was taken from the ancient music. So the music was transferred to the new Christian music, and we celebrate this music to today. Since the 7th or 8th century, they were collected in, or they were structured, like I would say, in the Beth Gazo, the Book of Treasures. And the problem of these treasures are they were transferred orally. We didn't have any music notation for these hymns. The first one who tried that was Nur Iskander. Nur Iskander is an outstanding, very well-known composer, Assyrian composer from Syria. He's on the level of Syria, also very known. He was the first who documented the Beth Gazel, around 700 hymns from the Syrian church, as notation. He released two books. This is one of the books, as you see, in form of notation, each hymn with the notation. So this was 1992, this book. This is the first really good step to document, to preserve these hymns. And he also released another book. I have brought to you only a short clip or a short audio clip to demonstrate how our neighbors, in this case the Muslim world, took the church music for their own. I took an opera from Nur Iskander, who displayed that in a kind of choirs. One choir is from the church, the other choir is from a mosque. So let's hear that together.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Well, the second part was from the mosque. So I assume for your ears there was no difference, right? So this is the clear evidence how church music, influenced the neighboring, in this case the Islam world. For us, it was for me very interesting to know that, because for the Western part, I belong to the Western Assyrian community, was as the first popular songs were released before 50 years, around 50 years, people says, always says, it's a sin to sing in our language. So I started to research, why is it a sin to sing? To sing, first of all. And I found it's only a short research for me, is that we have in our language, in the Holy Bible, in the Bible, in this first or in this chapter of Paul's letter to Galatians, we have in the Syriac version the word zmoro. Zmoro is for us singing. But I didn't find in other languages the translation singing. I found in English is revelings. And the same we have here in the letter of Peter. He says also here, bazmor. Zmor is, as I said, singing. So this is for me the first clue why our church father, because after that we have our church fathers of the Syriac-orthodox or Syrian church, they, you can say, banned singing or secular singing. Of course we have singing in the church, this is allowed. But all that the church was like a ban to sing. As I said, I did a little more research in my last book about that. But however, we still had some popular songs, folk songs. I found it in some documentation, especially Western researcher, Sochin. I assume you know him very well. I saw this song in his book. He didn't mention anything about the song, but only printed it. But it's a song. And the same I found here. This is from the Mosul area. This is a wedding song with a translation also. We have for the eastern part, we have for the eastern part also ancient or old folk songs. We have Rabi, the name is Rabi. I will give you one example of this kind of singing. This was singing in Hakkari, the Hakkari region, in the villages of Hakkari. And they used to sing such kind of songs. This is a presentation from the Khabr area before the conflict. Several kinds of singing, but my focus is the modern music, that means the documented recorded music. So what we will find in the early stage is that Assyrians used to sing, especially West Assyrians, but in other languages. So the first one I met with a record is this man, his name is Khosrov Malul. He was born in Diyarbakir, in Omid, he said in our language, and then moved to, or emigrated to the USA. We have here some Kurd colleagues, right? Kurd? I assume, it's I don't have the confirmation, that this guy released the first Kurdish record in the US, or maybe ever, because it was 1912. These are two records of him. he used to sing in Turkish or Kurdish. As I said, especially from Diyarbakir, our people lost their language for a long time. Most of them didn't speak our language, they spoke Turkish or Kurdish, and partly also Armenian. So this is the oldest record I found yet, 1912, but as I said, Kurdish or Turkish. However, we had, at the end of the 19th century, it was the time of awakening, national awakening of Armenians, also of Assyrians. And then it's what started to see some music bands or choirs. These are some old pictures I found. However, with the massacres and genocide in 1915, many of them were killed or dispersed all over the world. By the way, Syriani Gyrgi, I can tell you this story of this guy. This singer, Syriani Gyrgi, it means Gyrgyz in our language, George. It is, I heard from all the people from us that this singer was called to the Sultan regularly to sing in front of the Sultan. So, just to give you a short view how we start to document or to search our heritage. As you saw, we are dispersed in all over the world. It's now difficult to find a record released in Boston in 1920, for example, 1930. So the first step was we searched in old magazines. This is one of such a magazine, the New Assyria. And in one issue, I found this advert, 1917. I was always surprised because I thought the oldest Assyrian record was 1930. And here it says, in 1917 we have Assyrian records. I thank always the internet, first of all, then Mr. Zuckerberg, and then of course eBay too, because it took several years. We didn't find any information about this record, 1917. I asked the people in the area, they don't recall or remember anything about that. But a guy in the US, guy in Reagan, by the way, found this in a market and wanted to sell it in eBay. So we have here Assyrian records, reported Suriae is written on it. It's Assyrian record. And we bought that. We have now the number 2, 3, 4. Number 1 is still missing. We don't have it. Maybe it is number 5, we don't know. But however, we have three of them. The language is Eastern Assyrian. The music is very interesting. If you read it here, here is written Arshin Malalan. Arshin Malalan, I think you should know that though. It's a classic operetta from Azerbaijan. Here you have the advert of that time of the Azeri version. And the composer of this operetta was Uzer Hacıbiyov. So here you can say we gave our neighbors our church music and took from them popular music back. Do you want to hear a little bit from this record?
Yes.
So the next record we didn't know about it was in Eastern or in Western Assyrian or Western or in Surite. Now it was in classical Syriac, so we know you. Also here we found information in one magazine, Al-Hikmah, Al-Khumtho. This was published in Jerusalem at that time, 1930 at that time. And in one of these in this issue, found this information that there are new records composed or released by known researcher, you can say, or scholar, Naumfayek. Naumfayek, we have every year a special day for this guy, for this man. He's very known for his ideas, writings, and magazines. And as I said, I wonder that we found something during his lifetime, because the record is mentioned here was 1929. Although this takes time till we get a view about this record, here you can hear it. Church hymn, which he took for his work. The next we found is again from Urmia. This madam or singer Murasa Usham Daniels. She also released in the USA the her records. She also took or recorded two Azeri songs in Azeri. This one is Assyrian. These are the records where she sings in Turkish, in Azeri, and also in Persian. She sings also song. Coming back, the first original composer in the western part for us is this musician, Gabriel Assad. He composed his first song in 1929. He was music teacher in Qamishli, and interestingly his students became, you can say, pillars of our modern music. Many names which produce a lot of new modern folk songs. He produced or released two books, these two books. This one is a collection of songs, his songs and songs of others. Now I need. Now I let you hear from the 50s and 60s from Qamishli some songs of Gabriel Assad with the voice of a singer, a female singer and a male singer. You can see now their names also. Bardelli is normally is Arabic. I don't research in other language than our language because I try to preserve this language. But I asked myself what was in Mardin different. And I found these guys, this family, the Fengji family. and they are very known. I think one song from them. Maybe you know it because it's very popular. Maybe it's known. It's a very known folk song, but they have a lot of other songs. They came from Mali, so they give for the Turkish music in this case. So I come back from Kamishli. This guy, he was Armenian. We have also Armenian here. Aram Melikian, the crown, was the singer for all our weddings in Kamishli of the 60s. It was forbidden for us to sing. So he sang in Turkish, in Armenian, in Kurdish, but we hadn't any songs in our language. So till some picture in that from that area, we had church choirs. Here you can see some pictures. By the way, this musician, Muhammad Aziz Zaza, he was student of Gabriel Assad, is now professor in Arabic at university for music. So this is another example of interaction between the people. So coming back to the first West Assyrian folk song. This came from the idea, why did we dance on Turkish, Kurdish, or Armenian, or what else, Arabic? So why don't we have our own song? And this is the writer of the first song, Ben Hudahro, and this is the composer. And they took in the first recording also an Armenian folk music, the music from Armenian folk and also from Arabic folk. And the singer was Habib Musa. So that now I can hear the first song. Story about how they recorded that, because they feared the state for recording such songs, but at the end nothing happened. Lourdes Canel is very known, as you saw in the beginning of my presentation. He had also a lot of modern Assyrian folk songs. He composed them, he's a composer. Also the Khabur area, we have the East Assyrians who were resettled from Iraq in 1935, from Iraq to the Khabur villages. And there we have also a music scene or a lot of singers. So I will, because the time is running, I have of course a piece of music here, but I will get to Iran. Iran, there is a little bit difference for our ears, for our Oriental ears, because we have there many, let's say, masters of music, and they used, the great one of them is William Damien. He produced such work, very heavy notation, and I would like to hear one song of his work, and then you will understand me.
Thank you.
is maybe very Western, classical, operetta, but at the end I have another recording. It is oriental melody at the end, Assyrian melody. We have in Iran many singers who start to sing in Persian. One of them is Ivan Agassi. You see her his records in Persian language. He produced a lot of albums. I will go through that. In Iraq, the first leader or the head of the conservatorium, music conservatory, was an Assyrian. His name was Hanna Butos. He also released a record in 1931. We have here a church song, but we have also one popular song. And two pillars of, I would say, Arabic music were originally from Turabdin, from Turkey, the Bashir brothers. Jamil and Emir Bashir are very known in the Arabic world for their plays oud and also their books about oud. But for Assyrian music, Jamil Bashir played a bigger role or a greater role than his brother, because he opened a studio for recording and called singers to record in his studio. Many singers of that time recorded their songs there. I will let you hear two or three songs of that time. Before I finish my part, is one very recent event. Maybe you heard about that Arab Idol. The winner of this match, or this contest, was Yaqub Shaheen. He's of course a deacon of our church, so he knows the hymns, the church hymns, and like this singing, or this was his secret of winning, as he says. So this is why I said again as an example of interaction between the cultures of Arabic or Assyrian, and the recent evidence is this guy. So at the end of my part, I have a short movie. It's very interesting to see a song where many people or many nations sing it their way. I took a song from Turabdin, southeast Turkey, and the video, the movie is normally 13 minutes, but I cut it for I think 2 minutes, or yes, 2 minutes, just to give you. I saw the music is great, the pictures you see, the people, the colors, very very nice video. So enjoy.
Bir bahçede, bir bahçede.
Presentation. Normally I have 1.5 to 2 hours for my part, but I think I could manage it a little bit smaller. And of course, as I said in my beginning, it's the first time I give such a lecture. Normally I have a focus for our own Assyrian music, and of course a deeper research of that. But however, it's a nice experience for me to have such an audience. Maybe you can also help in my research, my further research. Here it says Tawdi Sagi, that means thank you very much for your attendance, for your hearing me. Of course you have the chance to buy my books. I will be happy, of course. We have them outside. My last book is this one. I added also a CD with 60 music pieces, starting from 1917 till today. The sample of songs. So, this is my part. Now I think it's open for questions, right? Thank you very much.